We've been talking a lot about connectors, but selecting the right wire is just as important. I'm Mark from Drone Lab, and this is Silicone Wire Measured and Tested from a Drone Making Perspective. In this video, we'll be focusing on silicone wire, as we strongly recommend using it for drones. Thanks to its construction out of tiny tinned copper strands and soft silicone rubber, these wires are very flexible and therefore handle vibrations very well. The silicone itself can handle 200 degrees Celsius, which makes it easy to solder without damaging the insulation material. But to help you pick the right thickness of wire for your drone, we tested a set of common wire gauges on our 600 ampere power supply. We used the same criteria as we had for our connector tests. That is, we're looking for how much current can a given wire take for 10 seconds without sustaining permanent damage. The 18 gauge seen here has obviously failed the 90 amp challenge, but even if a wire didn't ignite, but release smoke, we would still consider that test failed. That smoke is a clear indication that the wire has been pushed way beyond its 200 degree rating, and the silicone in the insulation is degrading. It will become more brittle, and it might at some point fail and reveal the wire underneath. If you ever notice that your wires are discolored, like the one seen here, you should really consider replacing them, preferably with a thicker one. So, onto the results, and they are very straightforward. Those are the wire gauges, and the currents that we tested are safe for 10 seconds. You may now pause the video and read through the numbers, or you could go to dronelab.se, where we upload all of our data in higher detail. But we're not quite done here yet. Because of the resistance of the wire, some voltage is lost when it's conducting higher currents. This is part of the sag that you may notice when you throttle up. We took measurements to determine exactly how much voltage is lost across 20 centimeters of a given wire at a given current. That's 20 centimeters back and forth, so the equivalent of a 10 centimeter battery lead. For example, with a 12 gauge wire at our recommended 180 amps, you're dropping almost 0.4 volts. This is as far as you can push that wire safely, but at this point it does get hot. And as the temperature increases, so does the electrical resistance. So as you push your wire too far, your sag will start to increase dramatically, and it becomes simply unpractical, even if the wire can survive a couple of seconds. Those are our results for the entire bunch, and to put these measurements into an even better context, I've added the expected voltage drop across a connector that matches each wire. And with these results, we can have some interesting observations. For example, if you have a small 2.5-inch drone that takes 30 amps in a punch and has a JST connector on a 20-gauge wire, it's well worth upgrading to an XT30 and an 18-gauge wire. You can reduce your sag by as much as 0.3 volts. On a 2S battery, that's significant. On the other hand, if you have a small drone that only takes 50 amps in a punch, but you're still using an XT60 connector, you might consider reducing it to an XT30 and a thinner wire. You only lose a little more voltage, but you can save some weight. And speaking of weight, we also measured how much exactly does the length of each of these wires weigh to help you shave off these grams. You can find a link to these graphs in the video description to watch them at your own leisure. I hope you'll find this data useful for your drone builds. If you have any questions, feel free to ask. Thanks for watching.